You mentioned kanina po, binanggit nyo kay Pangulo Marcos yung reform na ipatutupad ng PNP under your leadership. Ano po yung mga particular na sinabi nyo kay Pangulo Marcos kanina and ano po yung naging reaction ng Pangulo? Thank you.
Very accepting naman siya. Yung mga reforms yan is recommendatory 4 months from now. We're working together with the UP Public of College of Public Administration para makuha ng kompletong detalye kung paano namin ma-reform. Lalo na yung yung structure. Kasi very top-heavy yung PNP ngayon. I think we have 133 generals. Parang gusto ko i-whittle down to 25 para mas flat ng organization. We're very top-heavy now. So those are some of the recommendations that we're gonna make.
How soon can we expect, sir, yung implementation nitong reforms?
At the start of the second term, of the midterms.
Ivan Mayrina, GMA 7.
Secretary, napag-usapan niyo ho ba ng Pangulo kanina yung tungkol sa abduction ng American vlogger na si Elliot Eastman? And did he ask for updates and did he issue orders?
Nabanggit. From the latest information, it doesn't sound like a kidnapping yet kasi wala pang ransom demand in actuality. Parang merong local na hidwaan doon sa community. Parang hindi pagkakasundo. Anyways, we're treating this as a kidnapping and the police are in hot pursuit of the perpetrators.
Okay. Follow-up lang, sir. Sa nabanggit nyo, you said top-heavy ang PNP as an organization. There are 138 generals and you want to trim it down to 25?
That's my plan, yes.
Ano ho mangyayari doon sa... Are they going to be demoted?
No. We're going to let them retire and then... It's still a plan. It's not, but that's one of my recommendations to flatten the organization.
Is this a priority under your leadership?
Yes, it is.
Bakit, sir? Ano ho nakita niyong problema doon sa pagiging top heavy ng organization?
There are a lot of generals now without commands. If you look at it, meron tayong APC, Area Police Command, na wala naman tao sa ilalim nila, di ba? So, marami tayong mga lugar na redundancies na kailangan i-trim down. It's a 32-year-old law na kailangan bisitahin ulit. So, those are things that we will examine. Again, nothing's final. It's recommendatory, so wala pang ina-approve.
Alvin Baltasar first, Radyo Pilipinas.
Secretary, maganda umaga po.
Yes, sir.
Secretary, balikan ko lang doon sa suspension ng klase. So, meron ba tayong directive sa mga LGU? Kasi lalo-lalo na mukhang papalakas yung bagyo. Directive sa mga LGU na baka pwede maging alerto and maraming naghihintay ng mga magulang kung papapasokin yung mga bata.
May advisory na ako kanina umaga na suspend na yung classes for October 22 and 23. Ang expected ang height ng storm is midday tomorrow. I think from midnight to midday tomorrow. So I already advised them to suspend classes and to prepare all units to respond.
Yung level ng ano? Until, ng mga estudyante ng...
Until preschool to college. Lahat
college na, sir. Okay.
Pati preschool to college. Public and private, yes.
Hanggang college. Thank you, Secretary.
Okay, let's go to Chona Yu, People's Journal.
Sir, binanggit nyo rin po ba kay Pangulong Marcos yung balak na imbestigahan yung mga high-profile cases na namatay doon sa anti-drug war campaign ni dating Pangulong Duterte?
No, that was not discussed. And I think that's a matter for the Quadcom to finish. Yeah, tapusin muna nila at saka namin pag-uusapan yun.
Sa PNP, sir, ano pong directive ninyo? Kasi sinabi
nila they're PNP. Opening it. They're examining it. Pero it doesn't reach the level of the president yet. Kasi hindi pa kompleto yung revelations ng Quadcom eh. I think they will wait till it finishes before things are open.
So, sir, what's the update sa investigation ng PNP?
The Quadcom is not finished, di ba? Hindi pa tapos eh. So, yung corroborative evidence, corroborative testimonies, wala pa. So, iniintay nila lahat yun bago buksan yung lahat ng cases.
Thank you,
sir.
Clay Padilla, PTV4.
Hi, Secretary. Good morning. 18,000 barangays are at risk of landslides and the flood. Ano po yung nabanggit sa mga LGUs regarding evacuation areas and prepositioning of relief goods?
Well, you should be proud of the...
Benhur Abalas, who made extensive preparations for this beforehand. All of them have been informed. All of them are aware. And I think you've seen in the last 2 years na nababawasan ang incidences of casualties from landslides. And that goes a long credit to give malaking credit to kay Secretary Abalos. He really paid attention to that.
Okay. Eden Santos, NET 25.
Secretary, nabanggit niyo po yung pagbaba ng bilang ng mga generals. Hindi po ba tayo nangangamba na baka magdulot ito ng demoralization on the sahanay po ng PNP?
Hindi naman. They're all soldiers. So ano naman yan? They follow orders and we'll see. Again, recommendatory. And we'll see kung it'll take its final shape.
Gilbert Berdez, DWIZ.
Magandang umaga po, sir. Yung tungkol po sa election ay nabanggit niyo at meron ho bang particular na kautusan ng Pangulo na yung mga areas na dapat tutukan, yung mga areas of concern or hotspots na pinatutukan ho sa inyo ng PNP?
Again, 37 hotspots. Out of the 37, 28 ang BARM. We will cover that extensively. 38 hotspots, 27 are in BARM. Yung iba naman na natitirang hotspots, asaran lang naman yun eh, hindi pa masyadong, except for, I think, 4th and 3rd district of Leyte, where Albuera is, where doon medyo nagkakaroon na ng mga casualties. So, ayan, we will watch closely kung ano nangyari doon.
Okay, Tuesday New. DZBB, please pass the mic.
Hi, sir. Clarification lang, sir, para makumpleto natin yung advisory on suspension of classes for today and tomorrow. Yung lawak po, saang mga lugar po ito, and is this public and private?
Again, we advised all local government units to suspend classes in the entire Luzon seaboard. Buong Luzon yan. Again, hindi tayo sigurado, public and private, hindi tayo sigurado kung aakit siya papuntang Quirino exiting through, ano yung edge island sa atin na yung Babuyan dati? Batanes. So, we don't know yet the path, exact path kung dadaan siya ng from Quezon to Aurora to Batanes, or it will go from Quezon straight to the Cordilleras out to ano. So we will know tonight kung ano talaga ang final trajectory ng typhoon.
Buong Luzon na, sir, ang advisory.
Yes, buong Luzon. Yes.
Para safe na.
And that goes also with canceling all sea craft from traversing the Luzon area.
All right, thank you, sir.
Okay.
Okay, I have to make this clear. Ang DILG has no power to suspend classes. So we recommend to them to suspend classes. Yes, recommend DILG to suspend classes. Pero marami na nagsuspend. Marami na.
Okay. Secretary, would you like to also share a little bit of the ideas that you have for streamlining work in local governments?
Oh, well, baka naman makatulog kayo sa mga suggestions ko. Okay, just to give you an example, I was governor for 12 years. And sa 12 years na yan, minsan ang madalas ang buhay namin, pirma kami ng papel ng mga 12 hours a week. Pirma lang kami ng pirma. We want to work with COA, we want to work with ULAP, we want to work with various agencies to cut that down from 12 hours a week to 1 hour a week na lang ang signing ng mga documents ng mga mayors. It takes a lot of time and it takes a lot of mental energy and it wastes a lot of the leaders' resources, para time and resources para gawin yan. So we're going to make a streamlining digitization effort para maging mas efficient ang trabaho ng local chief executives.
Any further questions? No more? Okay, one more. Gilbert Perdez.
Yung sa streamlining po, sabi niyo po, bibilisan yung mga proseso sa mga LGU. E paano natin binabalansi yun? Di ba kailangan din natin ng dagdag na personnel paano binabalance ng ano?
That's what digitization is for, para bawasan ng ano, ang personnel at saka yung trabaho.
So, ibig sabihin po, yung dadagdagan lang yung trabaho ng personnel, hindi magdadagdag dito sa...
Again, that's what digitization is for. If you understand what digitization means, di ba, it makes it more efficient. Di ba?
Okay. We have Jean Mangalus. Please give the mic.
Hi sir, can we just ask, paano po dumami ng ganun yung mga generals na umabot sa point na wala silang command?
Nasa PNP law kasi yun eh. So, kasi they function on civil service rules na every 3 years ang promotion. So, kung qualified sila, promoted sila, promote. So, we want to change a lot of that to make it 5 years para mas mabagal ang promotion ng mga... Kasi nagiging top-heavy nga eh. If you look at the structure, I think there are 133 eh, if I'm not mistaken, 133 generals. Like, maraming mga provincial directors, after 2 years of service, full colonel sila, hindi pa sila eligible to promote, floating sila after 2 years. So, there are things that we have to change para mas sila efficient.
Hindi naman po na yung case na dumami yung promotions bigla ng past admin, hindi naman po ganun.
Hindi naman. It's function of the law.
Okay. No further questions. Thank you so much, Malacanang Press Corps. And thank you, Secretary John Vic Remulla.
Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome to your first Press Corps briefing.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Salamat sa inyo lahat.